Good evening and welcome to the Whiskey Lover Society with me, Gert Retief. And today we are starting a new series, and this is a series on the Tom & Tell Distillery, which is owned and run by the Angus Dundee Distilleries. And I started off in the previous series, I did a three-part series on the Glencadam. I will put a link on the description on all three parts, as well as part four, where I selected my favorite one. And for this series, we will be looking at also three whiskies from Tom & Tell Distillery. The first one is the 10-year-old. Bottled at 40% ABV. The second one will be the 16-year-old Tom & Tell, also bottled at 40% ABV. And the last one will be the 21-year-old, also bottled at 40% ABV. So for this one, we are looking at the Tom & Tell 10 years old. I've had some previous Tom & Tells, being the 12-year-old, and I will also put a link in the description for that one. And but today it's about the 10-year-old, so we are going to give it a quick nose, quick taste, and I will also give it a little bit of an after taste notes. And I will also, well, this time I'm not going to give it a score because I don't want to give away the game, as it is going to be a comparison in the end between the three of them. And again, I will be picking the favorite one, and you'll be surprised and who was my favorite of the Glencadam. So on the 10 years old, it is quite a relatively cheap 10-year-old. I've looked online, and the average price is around 30 euros for a 70 centiliter bottle. If I look at the 16-year-old, it will cost you a little bit more, so up to about 50 euros per bottle. And for the 21-year-old, it's going to be around between 110 and 125 euros for the bottle. So relatively expensive. But anyway, we're back to the 10-year-old. Color-wise, a nice little golden color, not excessively dark. It is matured in ex-bourbon casks. And so, considering 10 years old, and if I compare that to the one of the Glencadam, which is uncolored, so I suspect that we have some color added, and of course there will be a chill filtration at 40% ABV. So with that out of the way, part one, and we say cheers, and what's on the nose? So for me, the first thing that I get is a lovely sweetness to it, maybe a bit of a sultana sweetness in it, so a nice gentle sweetness on the nose. So at 40%, I don't get any of the alcohol. Even if I stick the nose in, very light on the alcohol, so the sweetness is carried out of the glass on that little bit of alcohol. So I also get a little bit of a youthfulness, which surprises me a bit. The alcohol doesn't, if somebody would have given me the glass and say how old it is, I would have say 6-7 years maybe. I would never guess that it was 10 years old. Oh, maybe it's just my nose is just getting used to with the 46, 48, 50 a couple of ones in the 60%, so maybe I'm just getting used to this to high alcohol, but yeah, I do get a little bit of a youthfulness in the alcohol note. A little bit of a ripe pear note coming out. That yellow pears that you get, I think it's the more the Asia type of pears, that the yellow one, and it's quite sweet on the nose. And first, and I get a little bit of a pipe tobacco. I think it was called rum and maple pipe tobacco. Not sticking your nose in it, but just when somebody open up the packet, you get that sweet aroma. That reminds me quite like that. So I also get the honey. It's not a sweet honey. This is a little honey note in the background for me. Of course, 10 years in ex-bourbon cask will give you some of the vanilla notes. I do get the vanilla notes. Surprisingly, after 10 years, maybe it's not first full bourbon cask. So it could be that maybe second or third full, I'm not sure. But the vanilla notes, it's not that prominent for me. And I also get a little bit like a mixture between the fudge and the toffee note. But I think it's probably the same thing. And I think because of the 40% ABV, the aromas are going down quite fast. So I don't think this is something that you would pour, wait 10 minutes before you drink it. It's every second I get something less in it. And now I get a little bit of a grated horseradish. I've never had it. A little bit, you know, I think a lighter than the wasabi, but you get it, little greeniness of it for me. Yeah, even a little hint of a sauerkraut. Yeah, maybe more sauerkraut, but not a strong. It's just one click up. Never had that in a whiskey before, that I get a hint of a sauerkraut or a horseradish. So a little strange one for me. Maybe I'm just going crazy. So cheers on the taste. They call it the gentle dram, Tom and Tell. And I think that this is what it is. It's a gentle dram. It's nothing jumps out, punches you in the nose, punches you in the mouth, kills your taste buds with some exotic flavors. So yeah, I definitely get that. So yeah, I do get the gentleness of it, definitely. A little bit of the alcohol in the mouth. The sweetness, it's a light sweet flavors coming out. A little bit of a toffee notes is definitely there. A little bit of the vanilla note, but I don't get that very strong. I also get the toffee notes, maybe also a little bit of a dried peach coming through. And what you hear, the snoring is my dog, so please, I can't get her to stop snoring. But yeah, she's snoring like crazy. And then I also get a little bit of a hint of pepper note. Not much, and that's a little bit from the oak. But it's the same oak level that I got on the Glencadam series, it is well balanced between the sweetness and the oakiness. And the oakiness is not taking over the taste of it. So quite enjoyable. So the oak for me, even after the third sip, I normally get a heightened sense of the oakiness. But in this one, not so much. I would not even describe it as the espresso or as a dark chocolate. But I would maybe a cafe latte, where you get a little bit of sweetness and not so much of the tannins. So for me, cafe latte would be a perfect description for the oakiness without any sugar. And then, well, the question for me actually is 40% ABV. And I haven't checked, but probably in the US where you get the extra 3%, I would have loved an extra 3%. I would actually like to taste this at 46%. I think that is going to be, for me, actually, the better one. I'm not even sure if I do make a 46% in the core range. I understand that this is a core range, so there might be something bit of a higher ABV. And I think it would be nice to taste this as a higher ABV as well. So, yeah, the finish, very short. The lingering little sweetness that lingers, you get a little bit of the oak lingers. And that's that. And a little bit of a dryness. And I actually experienced that with the Glencairn 10 years as well, that you do get a little dryness in the aftertaste. So there is, I saw on the website, they have won some awards with this whiskey as well. I will put a link in the description as well, so that you can also see the awards that they've been winning with the Tomintel 10 years old. And I'm not going to give it a score. I will talk about the scores on the last video when I do a reveal on which is going to be my favorite of the Tomintels. So with that, I would like to say thank you for watching. Also, please like and subscribe to the channel. Also, leave some comments. Tell me what is your favorite Tomintel. If you don't like the Tomintel, dislike the video, or tell me why you dislike the Tomintel. I would like to hear your opinion as well. If you found some other nosing notes, please feel free to make a comment down below. And remember to ring the bell so that you can follow the series on the Tomintel. So, thank you very much. Cheers.